What the ancient Egyptian priests revealed to Solon about Greece and the sinking of Atlantis. And I'm translating from a Greek article for you. Quote, so there in Egypt, when Solon went, as they said, he was honored with great honor by the inhabitants and asked for information about the ancient history of the country from those priests who knew it very well. They discovered that neither he nor anyone else, a Greek, knew almost nothing about the old. And whence he once wanted to drag them into a discussion about the old, he began to tell them about the most ancient traditions of Athens, about Phoroneus, who was considered the first man, and about Neovin, also told about Defkalion and Pyrrhus. Defkalion is the same man as we know of as Noah in the Old Testament. He told them about Defkalion and Pyrrhus, that they lived after the flood, meaning the deluge, the great flood, and for their descendants, and tried to determine how many years had passed from what he was saying and to date. One of the priests, very old, said to him then, Solon, Solon, you Greeks are children forever. No Greek is old. When Solon heard this, he said to him, how is this done? What do you mean by what you say? And he answered, well, you are all young at heart because you have in your soul no old knowledge of the ancient tradition, nor any lesson old from ancient times. The cause of this phenomenon is the following. Please support my Patreon channel since YouTube has again demonetized my YouTube channel. My Patreon channel will have 5 different videos from my YouTube channel every day. Thank you so much for your support and that you find all my content so interesting. You'll find the Patreon account details in the description box below. Many human catastrophes have been and will be caused by many causes, the largest of which are from fires and floods, and the smallest of countless other causes. For example, the tradition that prevails in your country is that once Phaethon, the son of the sun, after he had chained his father's chariot because he did not have the ability to follow the same path as his father, and on earth he set fire to it and he was beaten by lightning, killed, and this is called a myth. While the reality is the paralysis of celestial bodies orbiting the earth and the destruction by abundant fire at long intervals of beings on the earth, then those who live in the mountains and in high and dry places are destroyed more than those who live near the rivers and the sea. In our country, however, the Nile River, which is otherwise our savior, saves us even in such cases of overflowing embarrassment. After all, when the gods, cleansing the earth, flood it with water, those who are in the mountains are saved, such as, for example, the bucks and the shepherds, but those who live in your cities are carried away by the rivers to the sea. In our country, however, neither then nor ever does water fall from above on the earth, but on the contrary, it naturally emerges from below, from above. Because of these reasons, the traditions of our country are said to be very old. But the truth is that in all places where winter or heat is not excessive, there is always the human race, sometimes numerous and sometimes few. Whatever beautiful or great or in any way remarkable has been done, either in your country or in ours, or in another place by those we know by ear, all these are from ancient times written here in our temples and have been saved. But in your country, as well as in other countries, what has always been organized to be suitable for the letters and for what is necessary in the cities comes at fixed intervals as a terrible disease against them, a current from the sky, and leaves alive only the illiterate and uneducated of you, so that you become from the beginning again as young, without knowing any of the old that may have happened either in your own or in your country. So what you said before, Solon, for your own genealogical traditions, differs little from children's tales, because you only remember the flood of the earth, although many have been made before, then you do not know that in your country live the most beautiful and the most beautiful, better human race, from which you and your fellow citizens are descended, because a little sperm was saved anyway, but you forgot it, because the descendants of those who were saved for many generations died without knowing how to write. Because once Solon, before the great flood, the present city of the Athenians was excellent in the war, and in general, in its rule was perfect. In that city, it is said that good works were done, and the most excellent regimes were formed, from what we have heard existed on earth. When Solon heard this, he was amazed and showed great willingness to learn more, asking the priests to tell him everything in general and in detail about his ancient fellow citizens. So the priest said to him, "There is no reason for me not to do it, Solon, but I will tell you, both for your sake and for the sake of your city, but above all for the sake of the goddess, who is both yours and ours. He protected and nurtured and educated your country 1,000 years ago, after he took the seed through you from the earth and Hephaestus and later Ars. It is written in our holy books that the organization of the city here took place 8,000 years ago. So I will tell you in a few words about the laws they had and about the most beautiful things that your fellow citizens did 9,000 years ago. Sometimes, when you have the opportunity, we will tell the details of all this, since we will have in front of us the same texts. So examine the laws of that city in contrast to those here, because you will find here many examples of the laws that existed then in your city. First, you will see that the hierarchical race is completely separate from the others. After that, the class of craftsmen is separately organized, because it works in isolation from the others, without interfering with them, as does the class of shepherds, hunters, and farmers. Surely you have realized that the class of warriors here is separate from the others, and that they are not legally allowed to engage in anything other than war. You would have noticed, on the other hand, that their weapons are shields and spears, with which we, first of all, the Asians, were armed, because the goddess taught them to us, as she had taught you first in those places. As far as education is concerned, as you can see, of course, how much care the law has paid from the beginning to regulate everything up to divination and medicine dealing with health, after applying these divine sciences to the human needs and systemizing all the knowledge that comes from them. So the goddess was the first to establish your own city. After implementing all this organization and tactics, she chose the place where she was born, after she took good care of the good times of the year and understood that she would raise very wise people. So they lived in the city using such laws and governed very well, and had exaggerated all people in every kind of virtue, as was natural, since they were the offspring of nurture and nurture of gods. So many great works of your city written here are admired, but only excels in size and virtue. In other words, our books say how much enemy power your city once had, destroyed, a power which arrogantly, after rushing from the outside from the Atlantic Ocean, was attacking Europe and Asia at the same time, because then the sea there could be crossed, because at its entrance, which you call the Column of Heraclion, that is Gibraltar, the rocks of Gibraltar, there was an island. This island was larger than Libya and Asia united, and it started from, and starting from it, the people of that time could disembark on other islands, and then on them the whole of the opposite continent, located around that true ocean. Because these parts that are located on the other side of the mouth that we mentioned look like a port with a narrow entrance, and the land that encloses it very justifiably can really be called a continent. On this island, Atlantis, a great and admirable power of kings was organized, which dominates the whole island as well as many other islands and parts of the continent, besides which those kings ruled, from the parts of the mouth to Libya and Libya, Europe and Tyrrhenia. So this whole force after being concentrated and unified, then attempted with one of its expeditions to enslave both our own place and yours and the whole of the mouth from there. At that time, Solon, the power of your city stood out among all the people, both because of its virtue and because of its bravery. Because after overcoming everyone during bravery and martial arts, either the leader of the Greeks or completely alone, necessarily because the others abandoned it, after reaching the brink of disaster, defeated the invaders, that is, the people of Atlantis, set up trophies against those still prevented from enslaving, and released without any claim all of us others who are on the other side of the Heraclean columns, meaning the Gates of Gibraltar. After a long time, however, terrible earthquakes and floods occurred, and within a terrible day and night, your whole army was buried on land, and the island of Atlantis, which sank in the sea and also disappeared. That is why, even now, that part of the ocean is impassable and unexplored, because it blocks the very little clay beneath the surface of the sea, which was created by the island when it sank. This is from Plato's Timaeus, verses 22 to 25. And I've translated this for you from a Greek article, the Adrastika. Thank you for your support.